Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I know I kind of dropped off the face of the earth, but I did tell you guys for my 5 days of glam that some of it might be just on Instagram and the rest would just be on YouTube. So it's basically what happened. The holidays got the best of me. Literally, I am so happy they are over. Not that I'm ungrateful, it just was so many events, parties, get-togethers, that I'm just ready to be back into routine and not having to do anything, just being me, basically, and just going back to normal. I am so ready to take down all the Christmas stuff and just going back to normal. So I hope you guys did enjoy the 5 days of glam. If you guys do follow me on Instagram, you guys saw the last 2 days. I honestly was so obsessed with every single look that I came up with, and it was so much fun creating that and really pushing myself to get out a look almost every other day, if not every day, or if not every day, every other day. It was a lot of fun. So I'm excited for 2019. I'm excited to know or to see what this year has in store for me and my family. And I hope you guys had a great New Year's. Mine was definitely fun, definitely eventful, but definitely fun. I got to spend it with my entire family, his family and mine. It was a good time. So anyways, today's video is gonna be a really fun one for me. I hold this company like very dear because I feel like their first palette and their first launch was so good. It was so creative. If you guys do follow Gabby T MUA on Instagram or YouTube, you know that she created this brand from scratch. She's a Latina from Cuba and she's in Miami, or she lives in Miami. So the whole brand is based basically around her culture. And if you guys have been following me for a while, you guys know how much I truly loved her first Alamar palette. It was so good. I keep like all my favorite palettes. I have like a palette drawer and then I keep all like my most used or like the ones that I always look for or reach for on top of my vanity. And this one always is on top of my vanity. It's just, it has the perfect warm tones, but then it also has the really great pops of color. So when she came out, I've been waiting for her to come out with volume number 2 of the first palette. So when she came out with this beauty right here, I just knew that I had to snag it up and create a fun, creative look with it. And what I liked about this palette, let me pull out the first and the second. So it has the same amount of shades in it, the same size, same everything. But as you guys can tell, she added a mirror into the second palette, which I love just because it's so much easier to, when you're getting ready, to have the palette in front of you with a mirror just going ahead and dipping in, especially when you're traveling. I don't know about you guys, even though I do have a vanity mirror, I always lean to like smaller mirrors first while I'm getting ready, and then I like to sit back and look into the big vanity for like the bigger overall picture. I do the same thing when I have clients, like I'm doing their makeup and then I like to step back and like really see the whole overall picture of what's going on, because it's easy to get lost in like the little mirror. So I'm really excited that she included a mirror, and the palette is the same price. So for her to include a mirror and keep it the same price as the first one, that is like really cool and really legit. So I'm not gonna lie, when I first saw the colors in this palette, I was like, what the hell? What do I do with this? Like, how do I come up with like a creative, fun look without doing the other one? And I did come up with a good look in my my head, so that's what we're gonna do today. But they're definitely different color combinations, but that still flow. But I did watch one of her videos where she said it works best in junction with the first one. So as you can see right here, her first one has a lot more of like the warm transition colors, with this one being a lot more pops of color. But when you include them together, they create like the perfect palette. I won't be using it together today because I do kind of want to just use this palette by itself and see what kind of look I can create. I'm definitely obsessed with this Mambo color, this all like just matte yellow, delicious kind of color. If you guys have been following me, you guys know I just freaking love yellow colors all over the lid, into the crease. It's just like my go-to. But what I'm thinking today is I'm gonna create a yellow cut crease with this being all over the lid using this flamingo pink, hot pink in the crease. I know it sounds funny, but I can picture it in my head, so we'll see how it goes. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoy watching me create this look today. If you guys are new here, make sure you hit that little button down below before you go. Subscribe to my channel, subscribe to my Instagram. I'm the most active on Instagram. I'm actually going on live today with Jorah Cosmetics at 3, so I'm gonna, right now it's like 1:30. Ooh, it's almost 2, I gotta hurry up. I'm gonna create this eye look and then I'm gonna go on live and then come back and conclude and give you guys my overall thoughts on this palette. So just keep on watching. Okay, so I'm thinking I want to do kind of like a half cut crease with the Mambo color. Ooh, excuse the mirror getting in the way. But I think I'm going to pick up first Flamingo and dust this all over the crease as our first transition color. I'm actually just going to go ahead and use the mirror that's in the palette for me to really check everything out. So I already went ahead and primed my lids using concealer. I don't set them anymore. That's just not what I do. So yes. Wow, this color is definitely a lot more pink than I thought. I thought it was going to be a lighter blush pink, but it's definitely a very true pink. So I'm not going to lie, I've never used a pink in my crease, so this is a first for me, but I feel like this paired with Mambo and then that Damask color, that dark chocolate in the palette, is going to be so gorgeous. So honestly, I dipped into this color twice and it's like pretty pigmented. So you totally can do a lighter hand if you want to, but I definitely want this pink to really shine through in order to make that Mambo Hot like yellow really peek through or like really stand out. I feel like this pink is going to be kind of like the soft like star of the show. I don't really know how to explain it. I'm going to go into a smaller blending brush. This is, I don't know what it is because it doesn't have a number, but I know it's a Morphe rose gold brush. I'm going to take a little bit more Flamingo, but I'm going to go a little bit lower just to just deepen that outer corner. If you guys can tell the difference already, how much deeper it is when you kind of like pack it onto a smaller brush. I do want this to be a cut crease, but I'm thinking I'm going to do kind of like a half cut crease, kind of ombre'd out. And keeping the end kind of cat eye smoky is what I am thinking. Done like a full on all over cut crease with like yellow before and it was so gorgeous. If you guys just go to my videos and like scroll down, you'll see it. It was like with a ColourPop yellow. It was literally to date my favorite look. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back into that first blending brush, no additional product, and kind of just buff out the edges so it's not so harsh. Even though I know we're using the same color, but when it's packed on, it definitely gets a lot more hot and more like vibrant. Okay, so now I'm gonna take an even smaller blending brush. Let me color switch real quick because these brushes are so dirty. I haven't had a chance to clean them. And I'm gonna go into the color Damask, which is this gorgeous chocolatey brown. It does have like a hint of like, it seems like a little bit of purple to it. But I'm gonna take this with a Morphe M514. I love this brush so much. And I'm gonna focus this mainly on the outer corner in a, like a small little V shape. I just like to tap it on. And then once I have the majority on, I like to go ahead and do circular motions. And only bring it like not even halfway. So I'm gonna go back in and buff everything out with a different brush. I love how all their palettes are like not your typical basic warm colors, nudes, golds, bronzy colors. I like how they all have like a different feel to them, like a very like islandy tropical feel. It's like different, you know what I mean? It's not your basic everyday palettes that every brand comes out with. Yes, every brand kind of needs to have that like neutral, typical everyday kind of palette, but I like that she's doing something different. So I'm gonna go back into Flamingo a little bit and just go over those outer edges just to kind of blend it in inwards and kind of smoke it out. Okay, so I'm gonna go back into that smaller blending brush and take a little bit of more Damask and kind of flick it outwards so it can create that cat eye kind of feel later when we go ahead and clean everything up. I'm gonna go back into that blending brush with no product on it and just buff out those edges once again so everything seems very seamless and kind of blown in together. Okay, I'm gonna take a makeup wipe real quick and kind of clean everything up to see where we kind of stand. I love doing this. It kind of just like gives you perspective, I guess you can say, on like where the whole look is kind of heading. No additional products, I'm gonna go back into Damas and just kind of buff those edges a little bit more because it does seem a little on the messy side. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead, take some concealer, cut my crease, and be right back. Okay, so I went ahead and cut my crease. So now I'm gonna jump into the color Mambo, which is this gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous yellow shade right here. And I'm gonna be placing this all over the lid. Yes, all over the lid. We're going for hot pink yellow kind of eye look today. I just wanted it to be a little bit different and just play with color. So when it comes to mattes, I find it a little bit hard to pack on when you use a flat shader brush. So I'm gonna be going into a fluffy brush. This is a 518 brush. Once I pack it on all over the lid with this brush, I will go into a flat shader brush. I'm just gonna take this and kind of just tap it in. Yes, this is so pretty. I just have learned throughout practice that it's so much easier to go in with a matte shade with a bigger fluffy brush than going in with a flat shader brush because it can kind of look a little patchy. So I like to go in first with this, kind of buff it everywhere, and then to be a little bit more precise, I will go in to a flat shader brush. Trial and error, people. Trial and error. So now to get a little bit closer to that crease, now I'm going to go into a flat shader brush and begin to pack it on. I was a little scared of this eye look, but I am obsessed. And honestly, I'm not going to lie, it's actually not that difficult to pack on this matte yellow with a flat shader brush. Like sometimes I even struggle with like Makeup Geeks mattes or ColourPop's mattes using a flat shader brush. I just feel like it can come off a little patchy, which is why I like to go in with the other brush first. But so far this one is pretty good. Go into this little brush right here. It looks dirty, but I just color switched it, so I promise you it's pretty clean. And I'm gonna go back into Flamingo and just kind of clean it up over here just in case if we lost some of that pink. Dude, this is my first time using a pink in the crease and I think I'm in love. It is so nice. So I'm thinking I kind of want to put pink right here and then go back into Damas. I'm gonna take this Morphe M507 and take more Flamingo and kind of place it right here. So it kind of ombres into that Damas color in a minute. You don't wanna go too over, just a little bit. So when you place that Damas, it kind of just peeks through a little bit. Okay, and then I'm gonna go back into Mambo. And just kind of make it transition into each other. So now I'm going to go back into this small fluffy brush and pick up Damas and re-intensify that outer corner. Just so everything blends in well and seems very seamless. Okay, so I'm going to jump back into the first Alamar palette. And I'm going to take the shade La Costa, which is that first shade right here. And I'm going to use this to highlight my brow bone and my inner corner. This is such a gorgeous cheek highlight too. So I thought that I would have wanted to do like a little bit of a glitter right here to kind of cut the crease, but I think I kind of want to keep it all matte. I'm going to go ahead and do a wing liner and then just kind of go from there and see how I feel. Maybe I end up doing the glitter, maybe I don't. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and then I'll be right back again. Alright guys, so I went ahead, I applied the wing liner and some lashes, and this is a completed look. I was going to do a little bit of a glitter liner, but I kind of like the way it looks right now. It's very wearable, it's like tropical, kind of dramatic, but still wearable. So I feel like if you wanted to add a little bit of a glitter, gold glitter liner along the crease, you totally could, and it would take this look from a very kind of soft glam to a very dramatic glam for nighttime. I'm feeling the way it looks just like this, and I have no makeup on, so I kind of wanted just to see what it would look like with makeup on. Maybe I'll add it on at the end of this video, but I have to go ahead and go do a live for Jar Cosmetics, do my full face, and then I'll be back to come on and tell you guys my final thoughts on this palette for Alamar Cosmetics. So I'll be right back in about 1 second for you guys, but in about an hour for me. Alright guys, so I went ahead and I finished off my entire face after doing the live with Jar Cosmetics. I ended up caving and I added some glitter. I felt like it wasn't enough pizzazz, I guess you can say, for the live. So I wanted a little bit more of drama. So at least you guys got to see me before I went live with what it looked like without glitter. And now you get to see me what it looks like with glitter. I ended up just using the Urban Decay Midnight Cowboy and I mixed in a little bit of MAC Reflex Gold Glitter, which is why it has like the champagne kind of glitter, but then specks of like true gold glitter. It looks so pretty. So my thoughts on this palette, you guys know my thoughts on their first palette. I thought it was amazing. This palette is nothing short of amazing as well. The colors blend out so easily. They're super pigmented. Look at the yellow on my lid. It is obviously way pigmented. I would say the only complaint is like the colors are, for the average consumer, the average person, the colors are a little bit on the kind of weird side. Not weird, but just like different. They're on the different side. So like if you're somebody who doesn't like to play with color, if like this pink, this yellow, this green kind of scares you a little bit, this won't be the palette for you. But if you're somebody like me who loves color, has a ton of makeup, I collect makeup, I just love playing with color, this palette is literally amazing. The pigmentation is amazing. The blendability is amazing. The colors are awesome. Also, in conjunction with the first one, they are literally like a match made in heaven. So I get the idea and the concept she went behind, but as far as like the average consumer who just wants like an everyday palette, this obviously isn't gonna be the palette for you. But that's what I like about her brand, is that she hasn't came out with your basic everyday neutrals, warm kind of palette, or simple kind of palette. She came out with like a bang. Like with, she just came out and it's like, I'm all about the culture. I'm all about the tropical kind of feel, the Cuban culture, which is why all the colors are very bright. I love the names behind all the colors. They're so Hispanic. They're so Cuban, honestly. So it's just like, I get where she was coming from. So that would say that would be like the only con. It's not really a con. It's more of a con for like the average girl. But for me, I love it. I love the brand. I have no complaints about the palette. And I love that she added a mirror into this palette. It made it so much easier when using the palette. I just went ahead and used the mirror. And it's not like one of those really small mirrors. It's a pretty decent size. I can see like my entire face in the mirror. So I definitely like that. Honestly, in my book, she gets a 10 out of 10. If I was to take anything off, it would be like a 9 out of 10 because of color selection. But that really isn't a big deal for me. But I can see how some people would be a little bit thrown off. So anyways, that concludes my review. I hope you guys enjoyed watching me create this look. I am so sorry that you guys didn't get to see me put on the glitter. But you guys have seen me do that before in different looks, so it's kind of the same thing. I'm obsessed with the way this turned out, and I hope you guys are too. Happy New Year! Happy 2019! Let me know what you guys want to see next. Let me know what you guys expect out of me this year, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys!